I will show you how to configure Y sorting for tilemap layers and other game assets. You will then be able to make the player and NPCs move in front of and behind those assets in your top-down game. So in previous tutorials, we have created rocks, trees, and tiles in our tile sets so that we can then add them to our tilemap layers. To allow our player to move in front and behind the different assets in our scenes collection and tile sets, we need to configure Y sorting. Let's begin by going to our scenes folder and then the test folder. And let's make a copy of our test scene objects rock. So right click that and click duplicate. And then name the scene test scene tile map layer Y sort. Let's open that scene and we can just close this previous one here. I'm just going to rename the scene at the top and call that test scene tilemap layer Y sort. Then for the rocks tilemap layer, just right click this and we'll just delete that. Okay. Then right click game tilemap, add a child node and just search for tilemap layer. And then just going to rename this to objects. And in the tileset property, just quickly load our game tileset. And with tilemap selected, start to paint some of our new objects. So we've got small tree, large tree, and our rock here. Let's now test the scene. So just run test scene. And as you can see, the player can move over the tree. So let's just stop that. So now click on the player node and open the scene. And on the player character node at the top, just scroll down and turn on Y sort. Save the scene and then go back to our test scene. And then on the object layer, this is the layer which we want to affect with Y sorting so that the player goes behind the tree. So then go down, find Y sort and just enable that. Then test the scene. So as you can see, it still goes over. So I'll explain why. So when you have an object with Y sorting, the parent must also be Y sorted. So click game tilemap and choose Y sort. Then test the scene again. And then close that. And because the player is Y sorted and the game tilemap is Y sorted, then the root must also be Y sorted. So just click on the root node and then choose Y sort enabled. Now let's test the scene again. And as you can see now, the player goes behind the tree. So we'll test that with our large tree. And we can see that with our rock. Let's just close that scene. So now that we have Y sorted our objects here, we can always add them to this layer. If we just go back to the tile set and then click basic grass biome things, we can start to configure Y sort within a tile set itself. However, we have different tiles in here which could be considered Y sorted and other ones which we don't need to Y sort because the player can just walk over them. So things like small plants and foliage doesn't need to be Y sorted. So on the game tile map, let's just add another child node, choose tile map layer and rename this to undergrowth. And we'll just position this above grass. Then with the undergrowth tile map node selected in tile set, choose quick load and then game tile set. For this tile map layer, we don't need Y sort enabled, but inside our tile map, we need to decide which tiles we're going to use as undergrowth so the player can walk over anything that's on the undergrowth layer. So let's choose these following tiles. So we have this one and this one here, these small flowers, and then these four at the bottom are going to be in the water and the player will not be able to access the water. This small mushroom, and that should be everything for now. Once you've done that, let's just test the scene again. And then on game tile map, let's create another child node. Choose tile map layer node and click create and rename this to overgrowth. Then move this above the undergrowth tilemap layer node and in tile set, quick load and choose game tile set. And then we'll add the larger sprites, which the player can walk behind. So let's choose this one here and this one. And then the mushrooms and the flowers. Then on the overgrowth tilemap layer node, let's scroll down and enable Y sort. Now we can test the scene. And if we move the player does go behind the larger sprite. So let's just try this again. We're going to walk in front of the sprite and the player is walking through the sprite. What we need to do is add a bit of a collision shape just around the bottom of the sprite. For this one, I'm not going to add a collision shape because the player could walk through the sunflower as it's a lot thinner. And for the small flowers and mushrooms, there will also be no collision shapes because the player can walk through them as they're still considered smaller. So just stop that. So back on the overgrowth tile map layer, let's now add a collision shape to our tree. Click the tile set and we need to add a physics layer to our tile set. So just click add element here and leave it on the collision layer ground here and the collision mask also on ground. Then choose tile set and in the paint property, let's just select our physics layer and then just click on the tile to paint it. And then what we'll do, we'll just move these markers here. So just let's click on half pixel snap and you can zoom in, just hold control and zoom in and we will start to move our markers. Let's just zoom in and then just move this up. And then once you've made the adjustments here, click on here to paint it. Let's go to debug, turn visible collision shapes on, and then let's test the scene. So as you can see the small collision shape here, and then when we use the player cannot go through the tree, but can go behind the tree. Now, if we just move the player up slowly, you can see that the tree only goes over the player, or the player only just goes behind the tree quite late. So what we need to do is to move the Y sort positioning. Let's just close this window. Go back on the tile set. If we then go to select, go to rendering, and for this rendering, just click in the Y sort origin. And you can see that you get a blue marker here. And what we want to do is to just adjust that Y sort origin and move it slightly down. And I'm going to set this to about 8 so that when the player moves further up towards the tree, it should go behind the tree at the right point. So when the player's Y sort position is higher than the tree's Y sort position, it will go behind. So let's test the scene and go to debug, just turn these visible collision shapes back off and then run the test scene here. And then let's just move slowly towards the tree. And as you can see now, the player moves behind the tree at a better point. And that is because we've adjusted the Y sort positioning. Let's stop that. So I'll do the same thing for the sunflower. So just click on sunflower. Just move that into view so we can see the blue marker. And I'll also change that Y sort origin. So say about 8 for that as well. Then just quickly test the scene. And I can walk through the sunflower. It just goes behind the player at the right point. Just close that. And now I'm going to modify the rest of the tile set, adding some collision shapes to some of the assets and modifying some of the Y sort positionings. And now let's test the scene. So let's just run the scene again and then let's just move behind some of our assets. So we can't go through the tree stump and then the other tree stump, and we can go behind the log and walk up to the log, and then we've got our mushrooms and then we can and with the flower as well. That's looking much better. Let's close this. When configuring Y sort, it is best to use the test scene and then drop the asset from your tile set and also the scenes collection. As you configure the Y sort, if you do get any issues, There is a lot less components here to diagnose if anything goes wrong. Also, later, when we create the levels, if you find in the levels why sort is not working for a particular asset, you can always come back to the test scene and just check if it is working there. Now that brings us to the end of this tutorial on how to configure YSort for your different assets and scenes in the scenes collection. If you like what you've seen in this tutorial, please remember to hit like and subscribe to receive future updates of new tutorials. Thank you for watching.